Well, away from that, let's now look at some news that has just, you know, come in right now, which indicates that the Uganda Revenue Authority, URA, has ordered former presidential candidate Robert Kyagulanyi, commonly known as Bobi Wine, to pay over shillings 337.6 million as taxes for his armored vehicle. Now, in a letter to Chagulanyi's lawyers of Wameli and Company Advocates, URA Commissioner Customs Department Abel Kagumire said, as I quote, following the re-examination of your client's motor vehicle, Toyota Land Cruiser V8 registration number UBJ667, it was confirmed that the unit was armored. The details of ballistic protection were confirmed as 90 millimeter for the window upper plate glass and 6 millimeter for the bottom hull. Now, the document established that the declaration made via customs reference UGCHWHC54 of February 12, 2021 did bear falsehoods of clearing it as a normal vehicle, yet it was armored, which is contrary to sections 2203 of the East African Community Customs Management Act 2004. The document further established that customs revalued the motor vehicle using alternative methods of valuation and appraised a custom value of $166,700, which is equivalent to Uganda shillings 337.6 million shillings. Now, Kyagulanyi says that his car came into the country legally and cleared by all the relevant agencies. He further disclosed that his car was taken to the Directorate of Interpol in Kololo and the Forensics Department of Police of Nauru that also cleared it. Now, this is a story that we shall, of course, be giving you more details as they come in tomorrow. We shall be seeking all those people mentioned in here to elaborate more and be sure to catch the details on our news tonight. So let's now head over to Gulu District, where residents have given Umeme 10 days to stabilize power in Gulu City. The message was delivered in a letter or through a letter and sent to their offices and the Gulu City Resident Commissioner on the 20th of April 2021. Take a look.
In their petition, the residents, who are mainly traders, millers, small-scale industry owners, welders and landlords, want Umeme to fully restore electricity supply in Gulu City and the rest of Acholi sub-region within 2 weeks. Arthur Owori, who is one of the co-petitioners, notes that there has been a lot of power interruption in the last few months. He, however, urges that their petition stems from their meetings they had with the Umeme team and security persons in Gulu City. Owori explains that they have since denounced any form of violence and commit to following legal means in seeking redress to the situation.
Our entry point was the fact that the president's vision for the growth, balanced growth of the region is being frustrated by the absence of power. Actually, sub-region has actually lost lots of investors, would-be investors who wanted to come over and invest. We've had an outflight of capital and some investors who had come in this region at the medium level and at the large scale level. We're also saying that this has affected the retailers and the small scale users of electricity. Our pupils or candidates have also been variously affected by the absence of electricity in this region. It's such a huge problem. Barber shops, saloons, hospitals that use oxygen have equally been affected. Our petition brings outlines clearly some of those problems that we thought we would address or hand over to the resident city commissioner.
Gerald Egwal, who is one of the power consumers in Gulu City, operates a welding business where 10 youth are employed on a daily basis.
But this issue of power, if it's going like this, automatically we are now out of the business. We are losing money, we are losing customers. Everything is in a mess. To get a generator who can do welding, we can do the welding what? One. They like 15 to 30 kVA. Those generators, if you go to the market, not easy to get it. Between 20 million to 30 million. Where do you think we can get those kind of money? It's not easy. Totally not easy. Not easy. Not easy.
The corporate service engineer for both Gulu and Kitgum Umeme offices, when contacted, begged the community in Gulu City and Kitgum Municipality to stay calm. He notes that they have already put in place many facilities to improve on the power supply to their consumers.
All our works are projected to be complete by this month, April. Mm-hmm. Yeah, being that most of the work is done, so we are just finalizing. Yeah, and we have hope that when that work is done, we shall have a stable, safe and reliable power at Gulu.
This story was compiled by Claudio Mona for the news in Gulu City.